Support has moved online. This keeps you from having to wait on hold and lets us get you the help you need more quickly. Please open the web browser on your computer or phone and type the following web address. help.microsoft.com. There. Thank you for calling Microsoft. Goodbye.
Okay, this is crazy. You've got to like go on the website now to get hold of someone. Just wait. Hello?
The last time we called up Microsoft Support Center, we found out if you have a single end user license for Windows 10 and it's activated, then it's going to stay activated indefinitely. However, in today's video, we're going to be calling up the Microsoft Support Center yet again, but this time we're going to ask a couple of different questions. The first question I want to ask them is Windows 11, the copy that we're using, is that legitimate, the one that's getting leaked around the web? And then the second question I'm going to ask them is if it's indeed true that you can activate Windows 11 off a Windows 7 or 8.1 or a Windows 10 key. Though before we do get onto that phone call, today's video is sponsored by a channel sponsor here, SCD Keys, and they're bringing cheap Windows 10 key pro licenses for as little as $13 for one, or if you want to buy two of these licenses at the same time, you can get them for around $11.50 each after you use that coupon code BFTYC. And also, if you want to get Office 2019, then they've also got that available. I'll put the links in the description below for you guys. Make sure you use that coupon code BFTYC, but let's get on to the phone call and find out what the real deal is.
Thank you for calling Microsoft. You're speaking to Harshita. Could you please help me with your Microsoft email address using Phonetics?
Oh, hello there.
Hi, sir.
Yeah, my email address is Brian.
So, may I know the reason for the call?
My friend, he gave me a copy of Windows 11.
Windows 11.
Yeah, and I don't know, like, there's chat on the internet, like, is this real, is this fake, but it looks real to me, like, Windows 11.
Windows 11 is not at all launched yet, sir.
Oh, it's not launched yet, okay. But my friend, he gave me a copy and everything, like, looks real, you know?
Do you have a product key?
Yeah, I do, actually.
Okay, could you please read out the product key to me, sir?
B for bad.
Is it? Okay.
M for manner.
Sorry, T for tank.
T for tank, yeah.
Okay, just give me a minute, so let me check which product is this.
I'm not sure. My friend gave me Windows 11, and he said I could activate it with this key.
No, sir. This key says it is Windows 7 Pro.
Windows 7 Pro, okay. But my Windows 11 says it's activated right now.
Sir, could you please go to your Windows activation page?
Yes.
On the screen at the top, you will be able to find which edition. Please check for that, sir.
Oh, yes, it says Windows 11 Pro. And then it says Dev.
Windows 11 is not yet launched, sir. It should be Windows 10. Please have a check.
Okay. But it says activated with a digital license. Windows is activated with a digital license. That's what it's saying on the screen. I just wanted to know, like, is this Windows 11? Is this, like, it looks legit, you know, like, it looks like the real thing. And I was just wondering, is, you know, my friend. Is he, mm-hmm. I think he's a good friend, yeah? Mm-hmm. Like, is my friend a good friend?
I have no idea, sir. I can't judge your friend.
Okay, okay. But if my windows, so that Windows product key I gave you, is that's working, yeah? Like if that says active, if that says activated, is that activated?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Because I just want to make sure, that's all.
Sure, sir. There is no Windows 7 yet, Windows 11 yet, sir.
Okay.
We are still in Windows 10 edition, version. We have not reached a Windows 11 yet.
Okay. But, I mean, if, will Windows 7, will that key, like, I got this key, will that work for my Windows 10?
Right now, your Windows is activated, sir. So,
yes.
I don't think so you would require for the activation.
All right. Thank you. That's all I wanted to know. That's all. I just wanted to be...
Sure, sir.
Yeah, I just wanted to hear it from Microsoft, you know, just to be sure. That's all. Mm-hmm. So thank you for your time. You're very kind.
Sure, sir. Thank you for choosing Microsoft. Have a wonderful day ahead.
Okay. Thank you very much. So then we have it straight from the call center themselves. That was really interesting because the lady on the phone kept saying, yet. So Windows 11 hasn't been released yet. And I got that quite a few times. So I think Windows 11 is definitely coming, possibly tomorrow, this 24th announcement date that Microsoft's going to announce. I think this is Windows 11. I think these people at the call center behind the scenes know that's coming. So I think she kind of let the cat out of the bag by saying yet. So Windows 11 isn't released yet. Though the second thing I wanted to do was confirm my product key, which this time around they decided to ask for the product key and then they told me exactly what that was for. And it was a Windows 7 key. Now I use SCD keys, they're a channel sponsor. And so what SCD keys will do, they'll give out single end user licenses. When I check these, they're all retail licenses, and even though on their website it says OEM, they give out single-end retail licenses for either Windows 7, Windows 8.1, or Windows 10. And so all these product keys, whether it's a 7, an 8.1, or a Windows 10 key, will actually work fine on Windows 10 to activate it. And since we've got this developer copy, and it says Windows 11 activated there, I'm pretty sure that all these previous three generations of OS, once Windows 11's released, will activate Windows 11 as well. So coming out of this phone call, they just wouldn't admit directly that Windows 11 exists, of course, for obvious reasons, since Microsoft's already taking it down if they find the leaked ISO any chance they get. But if you manage to get a copy of this, I've said it in the previous few videos that we've done, it works extremely well. And it's actually, I feel like it's got less crap baked into it. So I do recommend making the switch if you can. I'm making the switch here at Tech Yes City because I feel like it just works better than Windows 10. I mean, mainly probably because it's actually a developer copy as opposed to it being a retail launch. But on that note, the most interesting thing coming out of this video was how Microsoft's call center support has changed a whole lot since the last time I called them. And I didn't call them that long ago, where the last time I just got a number off Google, contacted the number, went through, clicked what my problem was, and I got a hold of a call representative. This time around, however, I had to, I initially called the number that Google gave me, and that was directly to Microsoft. But then when I selected I had a problem, it like literally just palmed me off, would not let me have an option to call someone, and sent me to a website. But then I eventually found another link where I got a virtual like agent and I said I had problems and then it gave me the option eventually to call someone at Microsoft or have them call me. And so that's what happened this time around. I finally got a hold of a call agent and we got the word for you guys. And I guess That is, at the moment, Windows 11 isn't official yet. And of course, if you've got a Windows 7 or 8.1 or a 10 Pro key, then that will work to activate Windows 10, which is what the channel sponsor we use here, SCD Keys. They use the single end retail licenses and they get them at very good prices. So that's why I've been recommending SCD Keys here on Tech Yes City for a long time, because I know the keys work, they work well. I haven't had one of them ever deactivated. And there are these ones that go on eBay, but the eBay keys are actually the volume license keys or the Mac keys. These keys are not meant for gamers like you or I who just set up a PC at home and we use it. Those keys are strictly meant for business to business, where say they've got to deploy 100 PCs at a office and they just get one key and that services all the 100 PCs and it's easier for them to maintain their records. And these are never meant to get out to the single end user. So do be very wary of the eBay keys, because you're not meant to use them for starters. But on a second note, they can also get deactivated in the future if, of course, that agreement for those keys runs out with Microsoft. And with all that out of the way, if you enjoyed today's video, be sure to hit that like button for us. Also, let us know what your thoughts are on Windows 11. And if you've got any questions or comments about the stuff that we talked about in today's video, then drop a comment below and I'll try and get back to you as soon as I can. And with that aside, we've got the question of the day here, which comes from Fat Hentai Man. Can we get an update on this video? Been running the Tech Yes OS for a couple of months now. No problems so far. How do we keep it updated? And they're referring to our custom Windows 10 install that we did here on the channel, where we cut out a lot of the bloatware and made it from the get-go. You could install Windows 10. But I think with Windows 11 on the horizon, we're just going to wait and then we'll do a custom one of that once we can remove all the crap from that Windows 11 ISO. So stay tuned for that once I've got confirmation that you can actually distribute it and Microsoft won't take it down and whatnot, then we'll distribute that one for you. And if you're a gamer, then you'll just be in absolute heaven. And another thing is too, I'm enjoying the Windows 11 content, mainly because it does take us away from the GPU problem with gaming PCs right now, GPU prices and the whole crypto crap. It's actually a breath of fresh air for me personally, even though crypto is dropping right now. We do need it to drop a bit more before the miners will think about selling off their cards. That's when the big crux will come in for GPU prices, because the supply is already stabilizing now. Supply, these graphics cards are coming back into stock, but as long as the miners still have 300 days to get their whole investment back with crypto mining on one graphics card, for instance, then they're still going to buy up those graphics cards if the prices do come down between the prices now and the MSRP prices. So what we need is that one more massive drop, then you can see some sweet, cheap GPUs. And hopefully that comes really soon. Anyway, guys, if you stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes content, then be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell, and I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.